All right, I'm here with Richard Kear at Dance Boulevard on the Hawaii Party. And so Richard, the king of the West Coast swing. So let me ask, why West Coast?
Because to me, it has the most variety in music genre, in terms of not just the genre, but the speed of, you know, different speeds, and also even the era, like all the way from 1920s to current day music. And I had a music background, so I like to have a variety of music. So it's like you do one dance, but you learn how to do it like 10 or 20 different ways.
So you mentioned there's a swing feeling. Can you verbally describe it?
Sure. It's the feeling that's kind of fun when you're on a roller coaster, the feeling of buildup of tension, and then you accelerate, and then you unweight, and then you build up tension again, and you accelerate again. So it's that tension, release, that's fun. And most swing dances have that, but the West Coast swing, it's kind of milked and slowed down, so you kind of you stretch out those moments.
Okay, so where did West Coast swing originate?
I've heard lots of different versions of its beginnings. But the most common consensus that it did was a shoot-off off of Lindy Hop, which was a 1940s big band music swing. And that shot off into different swings like East Coast Swing and West Coast Swing, and kind of forked off from that. So basically it's a slower version of Lindy Hop to more modern music.
Okay, but it doesn't, you know, like the steps are, it's more of a slot, smooth type of thing. I think of Lindy Hop and East Coast, it's more fast movement.
Correct.
And like fast turns. I thought it was very interesting where you say when you do a turn, it's slow.
Yes, we underturn our turns. We don't overturn. The followers live for under rotation in the dance. We milk everything. We stretch things moments out rather than rush through them. So where Lindy Hop is very athletic, West Coast Swing is more emotional and kind of you're hanging on to the moments, right?
Okay.
So it's sexy and smooth in that way, but it can be done fast as well.
Yeah. So let's go back. Let's say 20 years ago, what was West Coast Swing like as compared to what it is now? Like, what has changed, if anything has changed?
Oh yeah, quite a bit has changed. On the music dimension, the speed has slowed down quite a bit. Used to be not unusual to dance a song with 120 and above. That was like your majority of your songs are 120 above. Now majority of songs are around 100 beats per minute, which is like walking speed. 120 is like jogging speed. And so it slowed down because aesthetically, or I don't know whether it was because of the music or because of the way the move, it's stretched even more and smoothed out even more. When it was done 20 years ago to faster music, it was closer to East Coast Swing, but it was very more rhythmic oriented. And now it's more flow oriented. It's very lyrical. We dance to a lot of songs that transcend even dance music. So back in the 20 years ago, we danced it most of the songs we danced to were actually dance songs. Now, good maybe 20-30% of the songs we dance to, they're not even really dance songs. They're songs you would sit and listen to and drink a sip of wine with, like really smooth jazz or something, or something that's very just acoustic with just a guitar and a vocal, not heavy drums or anything. Something you could do tango to. So the dance has transcended the original music. So it's a swing dance that doesn't have to be danced to swing music anymore. Swing music being predominantly dance music. So now it's danced to even more like esoteric, avant-garde kind of emotional, lyrical type music.
Well, I noticed it's also very interpretive. Like there was a song that sounds very tango or rumba, and then people can do their own thing to it.
Right, that's what I'm talking about. It's transcendent. You can dance West Coast Swing to not only music that's not swing music, you can dance to tango music or whatever, as well as to actually non-dance music. And so, yeah, that's exactly what I'm talking about. It's kind of, the art has transcended its original, its name, right? It's really not necessarily a swing dance anymore.
Okay, so let's fast forward. What do you would think 20 years from now? What would West Coast Swing be like 20 years from now?
Well, probably from what I've seen, West Coast Swing, the best way I can describe West Coast swing is that it always stays current. So it's always contemporary. So whatever the contemporary music, whatever the current music will be 20 years from now, whatever sounds and instrumentation and speed that invokes a certain movement that would match that kind of music, that's what the dance will change to. The dance changes to whatever music is being danced to. So whatever music is going to say, if 20 years from now music kind of did a full loop and became like 60s music again, the dance would look more like the dance it did in the 60s. So it's very musical, where it follows the evolution of music. The dance follows that. So the answer would be, whatever music is 20 years from now, that's what the dance is going to look like.
Okay, so I guess let's throw it up. Now here's another thing. So you're a very popular teacher. How do you do it? Not that you have to give away trade secrets.
I don't know of any one specific way. I guess what it is, to put it in a nutshell, I've found excitement in the problem solving puzzle and the logic behind how I problem solve. I get excited about that, and that's what I share in my classes. And I think in this area, a lot of people like to solve puzzles, and they tend to think like I do, and so they identify with how I arrive at certain solutions or explanations. And that's all I do. I just stay passionate with what makes me excited. And that seems to have everyone excited as well.
But yeah, you have like a way of explaining it, you know, how you transfer the knowledge, you know, how do you use the body and the feet and coordinate that, but
yeah,
be able to clearly describe all that. Particularly,
yeah,
I guess,
it's
one of Richard's fans.
Well, first of all, they're not all organized, and sometimes I lose control of the class. So I embrace that fact that every class is a little different. But my teaching approach has gotten to the point where I enjoy the discovery process. So I try to keep always a sense of discovery and help people, guide people into figuring out their own solutions, and let them kind of make mistakes and be sloppy, and kind of learn as they go. And I emphasize more on the communication aspect versus like being correct on the correct foot or the correct numbers. The mechanics are there too, but I always emphasize, make sure you're communicating and interacting, and that's what actually makes it fun and makes it always interesting, because as you know, people are always a whole world unto themselves. So every time you communicate or say something to them, it's going to be slightly different. And so that's where I try to keep everyone's mind engaged in, is that variety of dynamicness of interacting with another human being. And the music and the dance is actually secondary to the interface or the engagement with that person. And so I keep it very social, to put it in a nutshell. And now I'd say the other secret is that it's not so much me that creates making people popular. It's the fact that there's a lot of people in my class, and they come probably just as much to see me, they come to see each other. And so it's this dance community that has a lot of friendly people, and they come because everyone else is coming. You know how it is when you walk into a room and it's not very, for not very many people there, you walk away. But you walk into my class and there's people there, and it's interesting, and you want to get into that energy. And so I take only half the credit for that success. I think the community itself needs it on itself because of the social aspect that this particular dance art form nurtures. Very social dance.
Well, even though you don't take full credit, but we do want to acknowledge here with Richard Kear, king of the West Coast swing for the Bay Area, and we're at Dance Boulevard the Bay Area, but that's me. And so for the Halloween party at Dance Boulevard. And thank you.
Thank you.